vault where today we'll be entering the vault with vinyl records. Why am I sitting on the floor, you might ask? Well, you probably didn't know I was sitting on the floor unless I had a really, really high bed. The reason as to why is because you can see here that I have vinyl record holders. So it's a lot easier to sit here and take out a vinyl record and show you rather than it is to actually put them somewhere and then try and get them out. And it's just like I decided to do it this way. So yeah, so this is going to be my vinyl record collection. I hope everyone had a good Christmas and New Year's as best they could. Obviously with this whole new lockdown thing, we've already been in that until the end of January anyway, so it's just one of those things that we just have to get through, and hopefully there's sunshine on the other side. So I just wanted to try, and while I'm off, is to try and crank out videos to keep you entertained and to keep myself occupied as well. Sorry if I'm looking at myself on the screen, so if I'm not looking at the camera like there, that's why. So forgive me for that. So I have two sitting on my bed here. I'm not going to take these out because they'll feature in another video, which is the Star Wars collection, which is the volumes 1 to 6. So it has my favourite soundtrack ever, which is Revenge of the Sith. So it has that on it. With me being off since Christmas Eve, I've wanted to try and watch some TV and try and kind of watch things I haven't watched before. And one of them is Doctor Who. Now, obviously, I've done many a podcast to do with Doctor Who and Operation Retro Shock, but these are stories that I've never seen before. So I'm trying to watch it from in DVD order of what I have, from William Hartnell all the way down to Sylvester McCoy, and then watch some of David Tennant, Matt Smith, and obviously Paul McGann's the Doctor Who movie as well. But I've really been getting into the audiobooks, and one that I got only arrived today, which is this, The Evil of the Daleks. So this is a Patrick Troughton story. This is a Patrick Troughton story, and sadly, with a lot of Patrick Troughton, William Hartnell stories, the BBC thought it'd be fun to record over videos, because at that stage in the 60s, they were a lot of money, and some of them only exist as audio files. So this is one of them. It has 4 LPs in it, and I got it for an absolute steal of a price. I'm really, really happy with it. And I'm just happy to have that in my collection. I'll be looking forward to listening to that. So some of them, one I have here is Elvis, the 30 number one hits. Now, obviously, I know who Elvis Presley is. We all know who Elvis Presley is, but I can't say I know an awful lot of his songs. So we've got this to listen to and to try and enjoy some of his songs. There was somebody selling these. Now, there were some other records with these, which I didn't want. I only bought these for these two records. And I think I got them for like £4 and then a couple of quid posted. So there's this one here, which is the Best of Disney. Has the likes to say Whistle While You Work, The Second Star to the Right, Zippity Doodah, Winnie the Pooh, etc. on it. So I haven't listened to this yet. And another one I haven't listened to, but I got because I'm just a big fan of this and always have been while I was growing up, was The Muppet Show. I actually want to show you the inside of this. Now, this is from, when is this from? Like 1970 odd, I think. Just the inside of it is really, really nice. They are, you know, like just the stills of the Muppets and stuff. And obviously you have the classic, like the Muppet Show theme and the manamana. That's probably ingrained in everyone's heads today, for which I apologise. I also like to say, because obviously with me getting into records, the reason as to why is because my girlfriend Karen got me a record player for Christmas. She asked me what I wanted, and I had to think kind of long and hard of what to actually think about of what I wanted, and then decided to go for that. So next up is Status Quo, Rocking All Over the World. A lot of these older ones, the likes of this, Queen, the Beatles and stuff, were ones that my dad used to listen to. So I decided to get that. Next up is Disney Goes Classical. So this has some hits like How Far I'll Go, Almost There, Go the Distance, but these are all done, you know, like as in a classical score. It does have When She Loved Me with the Opera Men, and does have Let It Go and When You Wish Upon a Star. So some of them have vocals on it and some of them don't, but really, really nice one to listen to. My girlfriend Karen gifted me this one for Christmas, which is the Tarzan one, which is probably my favourite Disney soundtrack. Sorry, I should really, I'm trying to move, trying to put my head across so you can actually see, so that there is actually fine. So the Tarzan one, it's a picture disc, so on the other side has Tarzan, but I decided to do that because it's a nice one, as the back there as well. One that I got for, I think it was just £8 I got this for on Amazon, which is Frozen 2, the songs. So it has, you know, my probably my favourite song, which is Lost in the Woods, but it does have the likes of Show Yourself, Into the Unknown, etc. We have Michael Jackson, Bad. Some of his records are quite dear to get, and I got this for, I think it was about the tenner, but this is probably my favourite Michael Jackson album, so I had to get that one. A couple of Doctor Who ones. My mum got me this one. Oh, well, I got myself that one for £12 off Amazon. Apparently, it was damaged, so there's a little bit of a crease in the corner there, but for £12, I've not seen this on eBay or anywhere else, so to get this for £12 with free shipping, I was absolutely delighted with. So the next one my mum got me was a story that I hadn't heard before, which features my favourite doctor and companion, which is The Creeping Death. Which has obviously David Tennant and Catherine Tate, and it's a good story, which is always fun. One of my, obviously I want to get music like the ones I've shown you, but a lot of these will be like movie soundtracks, but one of these ones here I really enjoyed is Bohemian Rhapsody. I got this for I think about £15, which is two LPs, but it's really heavy and the movie of it is just amazing. If you haven't seen it, I would highly recommend it. I did watch that, and then I watched Rocket Man, but I far prefer Bohemian Rhapsody. Next up, we have Give My Regards to Broad Street, by Paul McCartney, which it looks kind of a David Bowie kind of esque weird thing there. David Bowie or Sting, one or the other, not the singer, but the wrestler. But yeah, I remember some of the songs on this, like No More Lonely Nights, which is on it three times. There's a ballad reprise, and a play out version, which is weird. I then got Paul McCartney, All the Best. So it has such hits like Live and Let Die and We All Stand Together, which is the one that always had him and Rupert the Bear pictured on it, if you remember that. We go from Paul McCartney to another one my girlfriend got me for my birthday, so thank you Karen, which is The Beatles Number One. This is just obviously like The Beatles' best hits, and because there's so many records of The Beatles, this one here is the kind of the best one to go for. I did also get The Beatles 1967 to 1970, which is like the blue album. There is like a later one, which is red album, but I got this for a decent price. Speaking of a decent price, I was in Sainsbury's because they seem to do vinyls, and got Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club, which originally was £28, and whenever I took it up and scanned it, it was £20, brand new, and I was more than happy with that. I also got newly recorded versions of the music from Game of Thrones. The reason why I got this one is Light of the Seven epic version. Excuse me. It's such a good tune to listen to, and I really like listening to kind of like classical music. That's why I enjoy the likes of Star Wars, even though it's not like classical music, but you know what I mean. I just enjoy listening to those kind of ones. So up next, it's kind of like the soundtracks from like movies, that kind of thing. So first up is the soundtrack to Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. You can see there's a price on it for $7.99. I have no idea where that's from. But yeah, I got this here because I always love that movie. And it has some good tunes on it as well, and nice pictures there. Next up is one that I managed to get for a really good price, which is the Thunderbirds TV soundtrack. Again, this has a lot of music from the episodes, the best ones being like Trapped in the Sky and Terror in New York City. But again, it's really, really nice to listen to. Barry Gray does a great job on presenting the music. Now, this is in French, so it does have a story in it in French, but the reason why I got it was because I haven't seen an English version, which is Les Masters de l'Univers. So Masters of the Universe, basically, from what you can see there, but obviously it's all incidental music, so it's not a case of you're going to have to, you know, obviously it has the main theme, but it's done in French, so I could actually say, well, this word must mean this then, etc. So I got that for like 15, 20 quid, I think it was. One that I was really happy to get to listen to is Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. I really wanted to get the Philosopher's Stone one, but again, music done by John Williams, and you can't help but like John Williams music, and it has Dobby on the back of it, so this is still one that I have to listen to. I might have to watch a movie at some stage. Obviously, one that I really want to get is Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade. It is a bit of a crusade to try and find this, but I do have Raiders of the Lost Ark, which is just as good. Again, more John Williams music, and how can you not love Harrison Ford, or John Williams for that matter? Next up is Star Wars Shadows of the Empire. This was, I think it was quite cheap, I think it was about 20 quid or so, and because I'm trying to get all the Star Wars soundtracks, I thought I would go for this one here. Still listen to it, but I'm sure the music on it is very good. It's music composed and conducted by Joel McNeely, except the Imperial March, which is composed by John Williams, so it does have that there on it. I did get myself the music from The Force Awakens, which, as you can see here, are picture discs. Ooh, and it has Rey on the back there. And then Craig and Sam, thank you for giving me The Last Jedi, which is the one that I needed to kind of complete the sequel trilogy. And was it Karen? And Karen got me this, which is The Rise of Skywalker, which again is a picture disc. I always never know where to open this from. Which is quite cool. I really like that. My mother got, or no, I can never remember whether my mum or Karen got me this. So I've got Rogue One, Star Wars Story. I did manage to find for a really, really great price the Clone Wars one, which has basically, it's like all from seasons 1 through 6. Obviously I would have loved to get the season 7 one, because some of the music on that is outstanding. Big thanks to Gemma and Dave for managing to pick me up the Mandalorian one, which is only available in Asda Living. Have you even heard of such a store? So bizarre. These are going for quite a pretty penny now on eBay, so thank you very much for picking that up for me. More John Williams goodness, which was E.T., which is the picture disc. It's so weird that it only has a wee slip to tell you what's on each side, you know. Yeah, so music produced by 1982. More like incidental music, which is Arrow. I really enjoy the music from Arrow, and I would like to get the music from The Flash, but it's not available on vinyl. You may have noticed as well with Star Wars that I don't have Solo. It is due to come in February because they haven't had a vinyl release for it as yet. So this one here has quite some tunes on it as well. One that I managed to get, which is Spider-Man Homecoming. Oh, sorry about the glare. Which is really weird, picturesque. I prefer the back of it there, but it's in really flimsy packaging, which is the only thing I don't like about the picture discs. My mum did get me Avengers Endgame, so I'm looking forward to listening to that. Obviously, Portals is such a tune on that. The only thing is that with some of the vinyl records, they don't seem to put them in track order, you know, so like Portals is on side A, number 7, and then there's another 7 after that, so it's like, I did also get the original pressing of the Superman movie, which again is a movie I've watched for quite some time, so I need to go and fix that. Mr. Smoker! Probably the first vinyl record that I got was Thunderbirds Are Go, which Dave gifted me many, many moons ago, and was in a nice frame, so I had to crack that out open. Obviously, Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 1. Volume 2 wasn't bad, but I really liked Volume 1, so I thought I'd get that. Some of other music, such 80s hits, Stranger Things, how could you not like that? The likes of Say, Rocky Like a Hurricane, Peter Gabriel, Twist of Fate, Olivia Newton-John, Girls in Film, Duran Duran. A movie that I just watched last month, December, November, was Baby Driver. I love the movie, I love the soundtrack even more, so I had to pick that up and went for that. And lastly, Rocky IV. Rocky III is my favourite Rocky movie, but Rocky IV would definitely be my favourite soundtrack from the movies. So, I'll lock that up later because you don't want to hear it all clicking and everything. So let me move over a little bit so you can actually see me. So yeah, so I just wanted to come on and jump back onto YouTube as well and let you know that the next video that I do will be related to He-Man and the Masters of the Universe. After much thought, I've decided to try and separate these over three videos. I was going to say three movies. over three videos because of how much stuff I have to talk about that. So hopefully that will be up next Sunday. Incidentally, I've used the word incidental and incidentally too many times in this incidental video. If you are watching this at whenever it goes up at 3 o'clock, please make sure the link will be down below to go and check out my friend Simon Michael Davies and his YouTube channel. He's going to be uploading videos every Sunday around 5 o'clock. So if you're watching this at about 5 o'clock, make sure to check out his video as well as my own and do like a double header, you know, like it's hopefully on his next video, I think, which should be up later on today or should be on his channel if you're watching this after the fact. Make sure you go over there because I think he's talking about his favorite 10 Star Wars movie tracks. So make sure you go and check that out. And like I say, we will be back here hopefully next week to talk about He-Man. So thank you very much for watching and until next time.
Excuse you.
That's what Herman Melville called it. Real old London piece of crap.